Classify community. So today we will be doing the three-phase synchronous generator construction as well as working. So first of all, we will doing the stator as well as the rotor construction point-wise. So see, the stator has three components. One is its stator frame, one it is stator, or you can say its armature core, and the third one is the armature winding. So first, let's begin with the stator frame. So the stator frame is made up of cast iron. So can you see this picture? So this type our stator frame will look like, and this is made up of the cast iron. This is made up of the cast iron because it is very much in good strength. It has very good strength, that's why. And it provides support to stator core. So this is our stator core. Our core will look like this, and when it is in this inside this stator frame, it will provide support to the stator core. So it must be in cement concrete flooring. That means this stator frame must be in concrete flooring. Concrete flooring means like this. If there is the cement like this, there will be the stator frame will be inserted, and there will be knobs which will be put in like this. So what does happen when the alternator starts moving in a very full speed? At that point of time, this alternator starts shifting from its place. That's why it is said to that this is need to be inserted in a cement concrete flooring so that the alternator doesn't move from its place. So in simple words, you can say it must be in cement concrete flooring because there is a lot of vibrations due to the full speed rotation, and this will shift its place. Second point for the component is that it is the stator core, and it is made up of silicon steel. This stator core is made up of a silicon steel because this has a very less hysteresis loop area, so this will give us low hysteresis losses. That's why silicon steel is used, and this silicon steel is used of thin lamination. That means after there will be a solid lamination of this silicon steel. Why they are not using a whole lot of a solid? Because they are not using any solid because if they use the solid, then it will cause a less resistance, and that's why I square R will increase. That means our AD current will increase, and there will be a lot of AD current loss. So to not to have that AD current loss, we will use thin lamination layer after the layer so that there is a solid thick lamination of this silicon steel. You can in simple words say that stator core is made up of silicon steel in is thin lamination. It does not use a solid material because it will cause less resistance, and I square R will increase, so eddy current loss will be occur. That's why eddy current loss will occur, and to reduce it or to lessen it, we use the lamination to solid. It was silicon steel because it has less hysteresis loop area, and this stator core provides the support to the armature winding. Inside this there will be armature winding, and it will provide it a support, and it will transmit a flux as well. And this slot inside this rectangular, you can see these are the slots for the stator lamination, and they are of two types. One is the open lamination or the open slots look like this, and the semi open look like this. Okay, now we'll move on to the armature winding. So the armature winding is basically made up of copper or aluminium. 95% it is made up of copper. That means if this is a stator, this is inserted in a cement concrete region or flooring, and this is an armature core, and inside this there will be the winding, and this winding will be made up of copper or of aluminium. It is either rectangular bar conductor, that means when we have a high power rating at that point of time we will use rectangular bar, and it also provide a space utilization, that means during the rectangular bar the space utilization factor is better than a round bar, and it is also can be round bar also when the power rating is low. So the three components are stator core and stator winding. Okay, now we will move on stator core and the armature winding. Okay, now we will move on to the construction of the rotor. We will see the construction of the rotor. Here also there are three components. One is a salient pole, another is a non-salient pole. Non-salient pole is also known as cylindrical pole. We will see the diagram, so then at that point of time you will completely understand why it is called cylindrical. And the third is a rotor winding. So see, the first thing is a salient pole. So salient pole is also called projected pole. So this is the salient pole diagram. So this is our shaft, and it will project outward in all the direction. That's why it is called the projected pole. Now see, it has large diameter. That means its diameter will be more, but its length will be less. So as I told that it has large diameter. So if a 3D face will be like this, that means this blue part is our hole diameter, right? This part is a hole diameter, and this brown portion will be my length. So you can determine that the diameter is more than the length, right? So salient pole is the same, that the diameter will be more but the length will be less. Now see, it has non-uniform air gaps. See, it before that it is used for low speed, that means this salient pole is used for low speed. Now why it is used for low speed? Because it has non-uniform air. So if there is another like this, okay, so it is inside, this thing is inside, so from here the gap is less, whereas here the gap is a lot more than this. That means as the speed will increase, the air gap will start also, the non-uniform air gap, which will cause windage loss, that the loss will also get more. So that's why it is used in low speed. If the high speed we will use, the windage loss will occur more. So, and this salient pole is also made up of our silicon steel. Why we use silicon steel, you know that I have already discussed. And thin lamination also, why use layer upon layer, why we use and not a solid material, I have discussed in the construction of the stator. So you will understand this there also. So I hope you understand this part, that salient pole is also known as a projected pole. It has large diameter but its length is less, and it will move in a low speed. Whenever there will be low speed, it will be used. And why this it will be used? Because due to the non-uniform air gap, which will cause the windage loss. Okay, now let's move on to the, so now it's a non-salient pole. So non-salient pole looks like this, and it's just the opposite of the salient pole. See, as it is a cylindrical type, that's why it is known as cylindrical also. And it has small diameter, that means the diameter will be small but the length will be more. So just the opposite. So if this is a brown portion and this is my diameter, blue portion, so this is my diameter, so it is less but my length is more. So just the opposite of the salient pole, and it is used in the high speed because it has uniform air gap. That means the high speed also, that means the speed will also increase and the windage loss also will be less. That's why it is used for the high speed, and it has uniform air gap. This will cause less windage loss. And here also we will use silicon steel, and silicon steel in a with a thin lamination, which will cause a eddy current and hysteresis loss but in less manner. Now the third point is a rotor winding. So this is also made up of copper or aluminium, and it is either rectangular bar conductor or a round bar conductor. There is also a damper winding. Damper winding means if this is my salient pole, okay. So this portion is our dampered winding. So here a damper winding are used, and like this the winding is also there. So now we will move on to our working of the alternator. Before that, let's have a revise the components. The components are, we have done salient pole, non-salient pole and the rotor winding. Okay, so we have done 6 component in total. In the stator also 3, stator frame, stator core and armature winding, and in construction for the rotor we have done salient pole, non-salient pole and rotor winding. Now we will do the working of the alternator. So from this one you can clearly understand that this is a stator frame, this is a stator core and this is a winding, armature winding. And this armature winding will be of 3 colors, that will be red, green and blue, because this alternator is in 3 phase. And this is our non-salient pole, and this winding, this dot are all my, yes, rotor winding. So now let's move on and see how does it work. So first we will give DC supply. So as we will give DC supply, the magnetic field get generated, and as the magnetic field get generated, the rotor also starts rotating. Due to this rotor starts rotating, a magnetic field also starts rotating, and due to this magnetic field starts rotating, there is a variation in magnetic field which get linked to the coil, and this coil, and inside this coil one induced EMF will get generated. So this is the 6 steps for the working of this all 3 phase synchronous generator. So what we will do, we will supply DC, and it will be then causing a magnetic field. Due to this, a rotor will also starts rotating, and due to this rotor the magnetic field also starts rotating, and as the magnetic field starts rotating, there will be a variation of magnetic field which will occur and will get linked to the coil, and this coil inside we will get our induced EMF. And if you remember the induced EMF formula, then it's very good. Or if you don't remember, don't worry. Our induced EMF, that is the RMS value of induced EMF, is KDKC 4.445 TF. So this is the equation for the transformer also, right? Except this two. So whenever we have some distribution in the winding, so we need to add this factor, which is the distribution factor, and the KC is your coil span factor, you can say factor. This is your coil span factor, or you can say pitch factor. Whenever the both of these will be given, at that point of time we need to add this factor, that is KD and KC. And this is 4.44, and phi is a flux, and turn per phase, we know that one conductor has 2 turns, right? Turn per phase, and F is our what? Frequency. So I hope you understood the working and the construction. So today's lecture ends here. Till then, be happy and have a great day. Now is the quote time. Every strikes bring me closer to the home run. I hope all of you understood the lecture of today, and thank you for watching.
Wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magus videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at class like community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.